Let us discuss various cases of projection of a pendulum bob in vertical circular motion. So we are having a pendulum bob of a string length L, and from the bottommost position we throw it with the speed u. We have already analyzed that at an angular displacement theta, the speed of bob can be given by equation 1. Similarly, tension in the string can be given by equation 2. We also obtained the direct relations for the angle where the speed becomes 0 and the position where tension becomes 0. One thing we have already studied, that in lower half of circle, the tension in a string will never be 0. Tension is going to be 0 only if speed is sufficient enough to take the bob to the upper half of the circle. Here we are going to analyze the various cases of projection. So, as case 1, we consider if initial speed of projection is root 2 GL. We throw the bob with the initial speed root 2 GL. Let's see what will happen. If we find out the angular amplitude of motion of this bob, as we know, the angular amplitude phi can be given by the expression cos inverse 2 GL minus u square by 2 GL. Here if you substitute u is equals to root 2 GL, you can see we are going to get cos inverse of 0, that is equals to pi by 2. That means if the bob is thrown at a speed root 2 GL, it is able to carry the bob to the position where a string becomes horizontal. Here final velocity of bob will become 0 and then it will return. Similarly, if we find out the position where tension is going to be 0, we can write, let at theta is equals to alpha, tension in the string becomes 0. This implies we know the value of alpha can be given by cos inverse of 2 GL minus u square by 3 GL. If you substitute the value of u as root 2 GL here, you can see again this will become cos inverse 0. So again we are getting pi by 2. That means tension in a string also becomes 0 when the bob reaches the position where a string is becoming horizontal, that is at 90 degree. So we can say at u is equals to root 2 GL, velocity of bob and tension in a string becomes 0 simultaneously when theta is equals to pi by 2, or we can say when string becomes horizontal. So this first case of projection root 2 GL is a benchmarking speed. If we throw the bob with the speed u less than root 2 GL, then it is obvious that it will not be able to reach the horizontal position. Before that, velocity becomes 0 and it will continue to oscillate in the lower half of the circle. And tension is certainly, it will never be 0, because we have studied that in lower half of circle, tension in a string will never be 0. And if we throw the speed more than root 2 GL from the bottommost point, certainly it will cross this position and it will reach the upper half of the circle. Let's study about those cases in detail. Now let us consider the second case of projection for a pendulum bob. In case 2, we consider if initial speed is equals to root 4 GL. So if we throw the pendulum bob from the bottommost position with the initial speed root 4 GL, let's see what will happen. We can find out the angular amplitude by the direct expression. Phi is given as cos inverse of 2 GL minus u square by 2 GL. We just substitute u is equals to root 4 GL. You can see this will become 2 GL minus 4 GL, that is minus 2 GL. So it becomes cos inverse of minus 1, that is equals to pi. That means the initial position, at the initial position, the speed we have imparted is sufficient to carry the bob to the topmost position. But in this situation, if we calculate the position where a string is getting slackened, so we can say at theta is equals to alpha, if tension is becoming 0, We know the value of alpha can be calculated as cos inverse of 2GL minus U square by 3GL. If you substitute the value of U square as 4GL, you can get it as cos inverse of minus 2 by 3. That is approximately 131 degree. That means, if we throw the bob with the initial speed root 4GL at a particular angle, where the angular displacement is cos inverse of minus 2 by 3, at this position the tension in the string becomes 0. However, it will have some initial speed because we have proven that initial speed is sufficient to carry the bob to the highest position. So, at this position it will be having some speed, but as tension becomes 0, now no force is there in existence which will provide the centripetal force on the bob. So, it will leave the circular track and follow the projectile motion like this. Because it can continue circular motion only when some centripetal force exists. So, as tension becomes 0, no continuous force is there which will be acting toward the center. So, it will leave the circular track and follow the projectile path. So, you can see, we just write down a note over here. That is also very important for various cases. It says if U is equals to root 4GL, then this speed is sufficient to carry the bob to the topmost point of vertical circle, but tension in a string is not supporting beyond theta is equals to cos inverse of minus 2 by 3. So, tension is supporting only up to cos inverse minus 2 by 3, beyond which tension becomes 0, so string becomes slack. So, it will start following a projectile path. So, it will not be able to complete the circular track. Let us discuss the third case of projection of a pendulum bob from its bottommost position. That is with the speed u is equals to root of 5GL. If we just talk about angular amplitude of motion, we can see the angular amplitude phi is given by cos inverse of 2GL minus u square by 2GL. If we substitute the value of u equals to root 5GL, this is cos inverse of, you can see if we put u square as 5GL, it will be minus 3 by 2. I think we all know very well that the argument of an inverse sine or cosine function cannot go beyond minus 1 and plus 1. So, cos inverse minus 3 by 2 can never be in existence. So, we can simply state it is not possible. Or we can say, in this case, when initial speed is root 5GL, during circular motion, velocity will never be 0. As no angular amplitude will be there, so velocity will never be 0. If we talk about the tension in a string, we can say, let at theta is equals to alpha, tension becomes 0. This implies the value of alpha we can write cos inverse of 2GL minus u square by 3GL. If we substitute u square as 5GL here, we can get cos inverse of minus 1, that is equals to pi. That means if we throw the bob with the initial speed root 5GL, it will reach the topmost position. At the topmost position, the tension in the string becomes 0. But it will have some velocity as speed can never be 0. And this speed we can directly calculate by using the expression 1, which gives this V we can write as root of U square minus 2GL. 1 minus cos theta. So, here cos pi is minus 1. So, it can be written as 2. So, if we write u square as 5GL, it will be 5GL minus 4GL, it is root GL. So, always remember that if we through the bob from the bottommost point with the speed root 5 GL at the topmost point, the speed is root GL when tension the string becomes 0. But due to this speed, as it moves further, again due to pulling tendency, again a tension will be there in the string, which will provide the centripetal force and bob will carry on with the circular motion. So we can say at bottommost position, if u is equals to root 5 GL, then it is the minimum speed required to complete vertical circular motion. Now we can simply state, if the speed is less than root 5 GL before reaching the topmost point somewhere here, tension will become 0 and it will follow projectile path. So it will not be able to complete the circular track. So in case of a simple pendulum with a string connected to a pendulum bob, u equals to root 5 GL is the minimum speed. However, just to take the bob to the topmost position, in the previous case we have studied that root 4 GL is the sufficient speed, but tension is not supporting, due to which it is not able to reach the topmost position. In continuation, we can see that if from the bottommost position a bob is thrown with the initial speed root 5 GL, at the topmost point the speed is root GL, which we have just obtained. We can write at theta is equals to pi, then from equation 1 we can directly write v is equals to root of u square minus 2 GL 1 minus cos pi, that will be minus 1. So on substituting u root 5 GL, we get it as root GL. So at the topmost point, as the speed is equals to root GL, we can simply state at the topmost point this tension becomes 0. So net force acting towards center of circle will be only mg. If the speed is more than root 5 GL, certainly some tension will be there at the topmost point and the net centripetal force will be provided by T plus mg. So the necessary condition, if we talk to complete the vertical circular track, it can be given that at topmost point the tension the string should be equal to 0. So we can simply write at t is equals to 0 in topmost position, we use mg is equals to mv square by l, because if still it is in circular path, this mg is providing the centripetal force. So here from this expression also you can get a speed is equals to root gl. Now we can also write a condition to complete vertical circular path by a pendulum bob. We just talk about condition to complete vertical circular path. We can simply write t equal to 0 at the topmost point, or more precisely t should be more than or equal to 0 if it is to be completed. And t equal to 0 is the minimum condition which is required at the topmost point if it is reaching there.